Hey everyone, it's Raphael from XX Raphael Productions, and in this video I'm going to be ranking the Speedster villains so far from worst to best. So this will cover seasons 1 all the way to season 7.
Alright, so here we go. We are going to start with the rival. So this is the start of the worst to best ranking, and I'll definitely have the rival as the worst Speedster villain yet. There's pretty much everything about the rival. There's nothing good about him. The actor was decent, but other than that, most of the scenes with him in Flashpoint. In fact, I honestly forgot that the rival even existed. He was seriously that forgettable. If you think about it, he was glossed over a lot after he was killed off in Season 3, Episode 2. His introduction episode was Season 3, Episode 1, where he merely served as a plot device to be Wally West's antagonist in the Flashpoint timeline, so I guess in that way he was simply a plot device anyway, so I guess that's the reason why they didn't put too much effort into him. But dear lord, could they have made his suit any worse than this? Because honestly, if you told me that this was going to be a parody villain, like a joke or whatever, I honestly would have believed it, because he was that forgettable and he was just not amusing at all. His voice is cheesy, his suit is awful, like I already mentioned, and just cheesy. This villain was cheesy in every way possible. I saw him in the trailer and I already knew that this was going to be a trash villain, but I was proven right again when I saw the episode. It doesn't get any worse than the rival, I swear to god for this. I guess the only good thing about this is that he actually lasted only 2 episodes, so at least we could say that we didn't get too much more of this garbage villain, so good riddance, and hopefully he doesn't come back. Now, again, like I said before, no hate on the actor. I guess he did the best with whatever script he was given, but yeah, that's it. So that's it for the rival, and yeah, like I said before, I forgot he existed until I rewatched season 3, so that goes to show how unremarkable this villain was, alright? So here we go. That sums up the rival, and let's move on to Trajectory now. Now, Trajectory only lasted 1 episode as well, but I would give her a higher ranking somewhat, because at least she was more enjoyable to watch in Season 2, Episode 16. Just saying, that's the episode she appeared in, for people who are wondering. So she also served as a plot device in regards to the Team Flash finding out about Zoom's identity, where they managed to connect the dots after Trajectory abuses the Velocity 9 serum and her lightning turns blue, and that is the time Barry starts to make the connection that the fake Jay Garrick is actually Zoom and that his story didn't line up to begin with, alright? So, at least while Trajectory was a one-off villain, at least her suit was also recycled for, what's her name? Jessie Quick, when she became a speedster later on. So at least Trajectory still served more to the overall plot, unlike the rival, and like I said before, she was still more enjoyable to watch as well, and it served as more motivation for Barry to get faster in order to beat Zoom, so this served as an effective way to speed up the plot of Season 2. So while Trajectory was also nothing special, at least she served as a good way to get the plot moving. Alright, so next up is Godspeed, and if you recall, just a day ago I actually made a video on why Godspeed could potentially save Season 7. Now, we haven't really gotten too much of Godspeed, but the little that we did get of him, he was definitely better than Trajectory, and especially better than the rival. So, his costume is actually decent. His costume's on screen right now for the viewers. This is how it looks like. Also, you can look at the comics as well. It's quite comic accurate. Now, what is not comic accurate is the origin story. So if you recall, the first time we saw Godspeed was in Season 5, Episode 18, when the show is showing us Nora West Allen's origin story and how she met Thawne and her plans to stop Barry from disappearing during Crisis on Infinite Earths of 2024, which is subsequently moved to 2019 at the end of Season 5. Now, the reason why I still have Godspeed kind of low on my list is because we have not yet seen the full potential, and I know Eric Wallace is going to show him later on in the second half of Season 7, where we might get a conflict with the real Godspeed. But as of right now, I will put him down at this, because that is what we have seen. We've only seen the clones on Season 6, and we saw the original Godspeed before Nora stopped him. But now that Nora has been erased from existence, that means that Godspeed has not been stopped in the new timeline, and now he'll be more powerful once he has perfected his powers. So, the voice is cool. I actually liked the voice, I liked his costume, and I liked the potential we have with Godspeed. Now, some people might disagree and say that, well, they changed way too many about Godspeed, and that he's not comic accurate, and that his suit is comic accurate, but his origin story has been changed a lot. So this might just be another Speedster villain that is nothing special about him. Well, let's just say that it's way too early to say, and I disagree, because look at Zoom. Take Zoom from Season 2, where a lot of people loved Season 2 and thought Zoom was one of the best villains. But Zoom is also not comic accurate. They changed a lot from Hunter Zolomon's story, and they also even changed his powers a lot. So, yet we can clearly see that Zoom is still a widely loved villain, so at least the same logic can apply for Godspeed, if the writers decide to play him correctly, okay? So, that's it for Godspeed. We have more to see from him, definitely, but as of right now, this is where I put him on my list, alright? The next thing I'm gonna do is Savitar. That's the next Speedster villain I'm going to mention. Now, Savitar, in my opinion, had a bit of wasted potential, but from what we did see of him from Season 3, he was definitely still good enough to make a third place, I guess. And let's go ahead and tell you why. Alright, so this definitely comes into play with Grant Gustin, because he acted very well as the evil version of Barry Allen. And at least, we could kind of see more of his acting potential as well when he's evil, and that is great. Grant Gustin delivered perfectly. Now, as for Savitar, the only reason why I have him below Zoom and Reverse Flash is that I guess you could kind of say that the origin story was kind of convoluted. Now, I know that there is a time loop where a Time Remnant fights Savitar in, 2021. That Time Remnant survives and then becomes Savitar later on when Team Flash shuns him, as he explains in Season 3, Episode 21. But I guess it's just kind of convoluted because they are leaving out the important detail of who was the original Savitar, because there has to be something that to kick off the time loop in the first place. Now, that also becomes more nonsense when you kind of look at Savitar's dialogue in episode 15 of season 3, where he kind of says, "When you created Flashpoint, you gave me the means of my return." So this implies that Savitar existed before Flashpoint, but then we get the Time Remnant version of Barry saying that he became Savitar, but Savitar himself was always a predestined loop. But the thing is that the show doesn't imply that when it has no references to Savitar in the original timeline. So it's kind of like two different plot points that are kind of contradicting each other. Now, I guess you could kind of say that the more you time travel, the less the rules apply to you. So that kind of hand waves away all the logic errors when it comes to his origin story. But anyway, so aside from that though, the epic fight scenes in Season 3 definitely make up for his convoluted story. We had Savitar's voice, which was epic. His theme song was epic, and this is one thing I like to mention. It's around Season 3 and Season 4 where the quality of the soundtracks of the season started to decline. This is the moment where it started to decline. The most memorable villain soundtracks were usually back in seasons 3 or 4. So I noticed around season 4, 5, and 6, the second half of season 4, from then on out, it's like none of the soundtracks really stick out. So I guess that's kind of sad, really. That was one of the strongest points of the Flash, was the epic soundtrack. If you compare Savitar's reveal scene, the soundtrack really carried that moment. It was epic, a lot of rewatchability, it was just amazing. Now, Savitar's suit is cool, but this is also the definition of basically style over substance. Like I said before, they took too long to reveal Savitar's origin story. I said this in a while back, I said it in a season 3 rant video a while back, where it took too long to get to the Savitar's reveal, and that really hurt the season's pacing as we were watching season 3 as it was airing. But the cool voice and the whole prophecies, like the God of Speed, the one shall suffer fate worse than death, one shall betray you, one shall die, all that kind of stuff, that was really intriguing. And while the finished product may have been disappointing overall, at least we were able to get a good first half for Savitar, alright? So, yeah, that concludes for Savitar. And you might guess, you might have already guessed who I'm going to put next, but we are now on to Zoom. Alright, Zoom is the villain of The Flash Season 2. He is one of the villains that was changed, like I mentioned earlier in regards to Godspeed, where Zoom's origin story was changed drastically compared to his comic book storyline. And but his name is still Hunter Zolomon, so at least you got that down. But this is one of the best speedster villains I have ever seen. Like his comic book character was changed a lot, but in a good way. So this is what I'm talking about. It doesn't matter how different it is compared to the comics, as long as they deliver in a satisfying way. And did they do it well? Because oh man, Zoom was one of the best villains I have ever seen on this show. And it doesn't get any better than his introductory episode, where he basically appears as a demonic-looking speedster where we don't know anything about him yet at the time. So we were left wondering whether he was human, he was a demon, or if he was actually, like, just an experiment gone wrong. Because I know Harry Wells from Season 2 said that he is human, or was, so that kind of gave more of an ominous vibe to Zoom. And let's go ahead and talk about why he was so good, because the voice by Tony Todd, he was great, he was ominous, it was dark, it was foreboding, he dragging Barry around the central city after demolishing him in a fight that badly. It's like, honestly, out of all the villains we've seen yet, of all the speedster villains we have seen, I think Zoom definitely gave the worst beating so far. He was just outstanding in this episode. Season 2, Episode 6 is the introductory episode to Zoom, just for people who are curious. And it was just amazing, like he decimated pretty much everyone's expectations, and Barry himself was crippled and had to regain his mental, he had to regain his confidence and his mental state as well. Like he was basically at an all-time low where he was scared to face Zoom again, and he was in Dr. Wells' wheelchair, which is the height of irony right there. I'm just saying, Season 2 was just one of the best. I really wish that the later seasons were as good as the first three, but yeah. So, let's go ahead and tell me more about why Zoom was good. So he was kind of a mirror version of Barry if Barry wasn't taken in by Joe after Reverse Flash killed his mother, and Zoom was raised in an orphanage where he was most likely abused, or I guess he was traumatized a lot, and he didn't really have any good relatives to support him throughout his hard times, so that was a good origin story for Zoom, and also showed us the origin story of Jay Garrick. Jay Garrick was Hunter Zolomon, who Hunter Zolomon stole the identity of the speedster from Earth 3, so that was a good way to tie in the real Jay Garrick to your main villain for Season 2, and it was also amazing to see, yeah, John Wesley Shipp is the actor of the real Jay Garrick. Yeah, I had to look that one up for a minute. But yeah, so that was one of the best ways to introduce the real Jay Garrick as well. Kind of like circumvent everyone's expectations. And then let's go ahead and talk about Zoom and why everyone pretty much feared for his life. Whenever he showed around, he had that depressive aura around him. And you just knew that stuff was gonna go down. Like, you knew stuff was not gonna go down well for the heroes whenever Zoom showed up, because they did well with his suit, they did well with his creepy presence throughout Season 2. He was just like, unlike Reverse Flash, he was just in for the kill. He was a rabid animal, he was in for the kill, and he was none other well acted than he was acted very well by Teddy Sayers, where he portrayed Zoom as a psychopath, and like I said before, the Zoom reveal, a lot of people personally thought that Zoom got less intimidating as the show went on, but I thought that was amazing, because Teddy Sayers did a good job demonstrating Hunter Zolomon as a kind, caring person, and then immediately transitioning to the psychopath Zoom that we all know and love, and that was just a spectacle to watch. He was a great actor and deserves more credit for portraying Zoom like this, alright? So that is good for Zoom. and he became the Black Flash later on, who is the Grim Reaper for all speedsters. And unfortunately, though, the only reason why I have him ranked lower than Reverse Flash is because he wasn't really used too often as the Black Flash. Like, this was a waste of potential, and he was killed back in Season 3 when Killer Frost iced him during the finale, so that kind of put him down a few points, and it's more of the writer's fault, actually, so yeah. Anyways, that's good for Zoom. He's one of the best villains, and now let's move on to the best speedster villain, and I'm sure you've guessed by now, the Reverse Flash. The OG speedster villain from Season 1, and it is none other portrayed by Tom Cavanagh and Matt Letzter. So, honestly, I think Matt Letzter is the better portrayal for Reverse Flash, despite having less screen time, but Tom Cavanagh definitely portrayed him in one of the better. He was one of the standouts for Season 1, and that is also because, like, that's the reason why Season 1 was one of the best seasons, because it had an amazing villain with Reverse Flash, Eobard Thawne. Alright, so let's go ahead and talk about the reasons why. The ties with Thawne in regards to his connection with Team Flash throughout Season 1 definitely gave a more compelling arc for Thawne in regards to him being, like, growing fond of his very own creation, where, you know, in his timeline where Barry is his mortal enemy and they are rivals in the future, well, I guess this is a good and compelling storyline where we could see Thawne growing to care for his own arch enemy because he has to use Barry to return to his own timeline where he got stuck after killing Nora Allen. And then, I'm not referring to Barry's daughter, but I'm referring to Barry's mother, where he killed Nora Allen at the year 2000, and he has to spend the next 15 years creating the particle accelerator, being Barry's mentor, and that is why Reverse Flash has not yet been topped as the best villain for the show. Not just the best speedster villain, but the best villain in general. Zoom comes close, but Reverse Flash is just too good to top so far, alright? And let's go ahead and talk about the acting, because Tom Cavanagh portrayed the fake Dr. Wells amazingly. He is the reason why the show has continued to carry on despite the show's flaws in the later seasons. It was mostly due to chemistry with the cast, and it doesn't get any better than Tom Cavanagh and Grant Gustin. And also, we haven't yet seen Reverse Flash's origin story. They've only so far told it to us in Season 2, Episode 11, where he sees the Flash Museum and blah blah blah, all that kind of stuff. But it doesn't yet get introduced. We haven't yet really seen in action. They've only so far, they've only told us but not shown us. So they haven't really gotten yet into the whole origin story of Eobard Thawne and how he created his suit, etc., how he grew to hate Barry. But I'm assuming they are going to save that for their last season, so that the series eventually comes full circle, alright? So now let's go ahead and talk about Matt Letzter, because he was another... Honestly, I had high expectations after Tom Cavanagh's great portrayal, and Matt Letzter definitely exceeded my expectations. He was the perfect comic book accurate type Reverse Flash. If you want to see his great acting, look no further than Season 3, Episode 1, The Flashpoint, and then The Legends of Tomorrow. Those are the times where you can see the other brutal shine of the brutal Matt Letzter's Reverse Flash shine for the audience. And this is the reason why I wish that they get him back. Because the last time we really saw him as Reverse Flash was during Legends of Tomorrow, and ever since then it's been Tom as Reverse Flash. But honestly, I think that Matt is the better choice for Reverse Flash at this point, alright? So definitely Thawne gets, and he is tied to the Crisis of 2024, so even then he is more relevant than any of the other speedster villains, where he really ties into Barry's true arch enemy and he really kind of get rid of Reverse Flash. So this definitely is why Reverse Flash is number one as in terms of my list, and hopefully you agree with this list. But if you disagree, definitely feel free to comment down below as to who is the better villains. I sometimes have Reverse Flash or Zoom interchangeably take the first place from time to time. But in regards to the overall show in the long run, I think Reverse Flash is still the top speedster villain, alright? So thank you very much for watching. That is it for the Flash speedster villains. I will probably make a sequel once you get more of Godspeed, because my list might be updated later on. But As of right now, this is what I have for Speedster villains. Raphael out, and I will see you soon.